Today, I'll show you how to use the DRV8300 DRGE EVM out of the box to spin a brushless DC motor using sensor trapezoidal control. The DRV8300 DRGE EVM is an evaluation module for the DRV8300 three-phase BLDC motor driver with an integrated bootstrap diode. The DRV8300 uses a hardware interface. The DRV8300 DRGE EVM can be used to take either inverted or non-inverted signals on INLX with respect to GLX. This is controlled via the mode pin R7 on the EVM. When it is left unpopulated or connected to ground, then the driver is in non-inverted mode. And when a zero-ohm resistor or a net tie is placed at R7, then the pin is pulled to GVDD and the device is utilized in the inverting mode. You can also use the DRV8300 DIPW EVM, but it can only be used in the inverted INLX mode. Both EVMs can be used following the steps shown in this demo, with the only difference being the version you select in the GUI shown later. For this demo, you will need the DRV8300 DRGE EVM, the LaunchXL F2800-49C C2000 launchpad, a brushless DC motor, a micro USB cable, and a flathead screwdriver. Let's begin. To start, connect the motor phase outputs to phases A, B, and C of the connector J5 by using the flathead screwdriver to screw the phase wires into the screw terminals. Next, connect the power supply. Connect the positive of the power supply to PVDD test point and the negative of the power supply to the ground rail. In order to use the Hall sensor-based application, connect the digital Hall signals, Hall power, and the Hall ground into connector J7. You can use your finger or the flathead screwdriver to push down and connect each wire into the socket. Ensure the Hall power select jumper, J3, is set to 3.3 volts Hall power from the onboard buck converter or from an external Hall power supply. Next, use the GVDD jumper, J6, to determine if the GVDD voltage comes internally or from an external supply. Finally, ensure that the ARF jumper, J8, for CSA directionality is selected for the mode chosen in the GUI. Set this in the left position for bidirectional current sensing and in the right position for unidirectional current sensing. Once the EVM settings are finalized, connect the DRV8300 DRGE EVM to the top half of the LaunchXL F2800-49C. The motor connector should be facing the top on the same side as the micro USB cable of the launchpad. Now, turn on the power supply. Using a 12-volt and a 2-amp current limit is a good recommended starting setup for lower power motors. Plug in the micro USB cable into the launchpad and into the computer. Now, we will connect the hardware to the GUI for sensor trapezoidal control using an application firmware from the Motor Control Software Development Kit. Go to dev.ti.com/gallery and search for DRV8300. Click on the DRV8300 EVM GUI to access the GUI. Accept the README that appears and wait for the GUI to flash the program into the MCU. When the program is finished, the hardware connected appears at the bottom left corner of the GUI. First, select the EVM being used. For this demo, we will be using the DRV8300 DRGE EVM. Begin by clicking Output Enable. This allows the motor outputs to be enabled. Next, select the direction you wish to spin the motor. You're also able to configure the acceleration delay and the CSA settings to your preferences in the GUI. Once configured, select the duty cycle needed to spin the motor. You'll be able to monitor PVDD faults, GVDD faults, and overcurrent faults, and you will also be able to clear them using the Clear Faults icon. For more information, visit the DRV8300 DRGE EVM and the LaunchXL F2800-49C tool pages to order the evaluation hardware. You can start spinning brushless DC motors in 10 minutes or less with the sensor trapezoidal control. Thanks for watching and have a good day.